Hi everyone, this is Willy. Welcome back to Singapore, Clark Quay. The last time we visited here was in March, and today we are here to show you how Clark Quay is like on the first day of Phase 2. Phase 2 is the reopening of the Singapore economy. Okay, so back in April 7th, we had a circuit breaker, and basically a lot of businesses, a lot of entertainment and F&B businesses have to stop. This is the situation back from April the 7th up to Phase 1, which starts from 2nd of June. We had a gradual opening of the country. So come on, let's go.
Hey, hi, 大家好。之前我有做过一个影片跟你介绍新加坡跟中国生意上的来往已经恢复了。你今天是19号6月来到这里的目的，我身在哪里呢？在克拉码头，新加坡一个很旅客著名的一个地方，来这里做一个实地考察，在阻断措施第二阶段的情况到底是如何，所以就跟我一起来走走吧。一来到克拉码头的这个入口，我们就看得到他们已经做好这个安全距离的措施，所以每个人要进去的，他们一定要做那个核力追踪的那个 check in， 然后同时他也有一个体温扫描器在这边，所以任何人进出这里都一定要经过这一站。可是等一下我们还会去别的地点去做一个考察，所以现在我们就进去看看情况吧。
So we have entered the premises via the scanner. We are now walking towards where the fountain is. From here, we can see that quite a number of shops have opened. And like compared to the last time we came here, it was really quiet. A lot of shops wasn't open. As we move forward to the fountain, I can really see a lot more lights, a lot more people dining in. This is one of the differences from Phase 2 to Circuit Breaker. Because back then, there wasn't any dining in allowed in all the restaurants. So let's go there, come on.
The 一个喷水池，可是现在已经没有水了。可是这个不是重点，重点是你可以看到我身后的这些餐饮业跟酒吧，其实他们都已经完全开业了，然后也有很多人已经开始出来吃东西跟朋友聚会。阻断措施第二阶段唯一最重要的重点是什么呢？政府宣布只限制每一组人不可以超过五个，这五位人他们不一定是要同一个家属，不可以每一组人不可以超过五位，在每一桌的不同的人的距离是一定要一米以上。所以你可以看到其实很多餐饮业跟酒吧，他们从昨天开始他们已经做好这个准备了，他们才有办法开始营业。政府还会继续派取政府的人员来查这些餐饮业跟餐馆有没有做好这个安全距离的这个措施，还要再去另外一个地点查。好，就跟我来吧。
There is also another checkpoint for entry and exit. So at every of these tentative checkpoints, they allow, or rather they enforce that you check in with your phone and they have a temperature check to make sure that your temperature doesn't go too way up, right? This is one of the existing measures still in place during Phase 2. As we walk earlier from the inside towards the riverfront area, you can see that some businesses remain closed, some businesses are not at full capacity, so our people a little bit uncertain whether they should go all out and party on a Friday night. And let's check out further on. We'll be right back. all entertainment outlets remains closed. Okay, they are not allowed to open. Only those F&B restaurants, they are allowed. And if they serve alcohol in F&B, it's also okay, but up to a timing of 10:30 in the evening.
大家可以看得到，阻断措施第二阶段其实也不一定是每一个人都会出来寻乐、出来喝酒、聚会之类的。可是还是有一部分的人一定会出来，因为过了两个月的阻断措施，每一个人都没有办法见到朋友，也没有办法跟家人出来吃一餐。况且再过两天，在新加坡就是父亲节，大家也看得到，少了很多的旅客，没有很多的人在大街上走动，大部分的人都已经聚会在餐厅。我所知道的克拉码头，在一个星期五的晚上，现在所看到的人数其实大概只是20%-30%，平时会看到的人的数量，大家还是也会有一点忌讳，他们就会怕，还是不知道到底要不要出来做聚会。我们的报道就到了这里，现在就可能去喝一杯吧，走吧。
Okay, hi guys. We are now at Harry's. You can see that our mask has been taken off. Why? Because we are at a F&B outlet. The regulation is allowing patrons to take off their mask to consume drink as long as they are within the premise.
来到新加坡的朋友们，如果当新加坡已经开放旅客进来的话，如果你们很厌倦戴口罩的话，你们就可以躲进一个随便一个餐厅还是一个餐饮业，然后你们就可以舒适的把那个口罩给脱下来了。你看到，其实我们现在已经叫了一杯啤酒，享受一下过了两个月的阻断措施之后的这个轻松的这个感觉。
If you like to go out, don't stay out too long as well. Also observe the surrounding and see whether the crowd is getting more or lesser. Don't take it that this is opportunity for you to live back life as normal. It's never going to be normal. There are still infection cases. We still should be on the safety side.
中国的朋友们，等到你们可以飞往新加坡的时候，我们就再见面吧。
Okay, see you. Bye bye.Cheers!